Hello students, good morning to all. So today we will continue our discussion lesson to input and output devices. Now in the series of input devices, today we will study about the microphone. This microphone is an input device to input sound that is then stored in a digital form. This microphone is used for various applications such as adding sound to a multimedia presentation or for mixing music. Next is the MICR, magnetic ink card reader. This is also an input device used in banks. There are large number of checks to be processed every day. The bank's code number and check number are printed on the checks with a special type of ink that contains the particles of magnetic material that are machine readable. So this reading process is called magnetic ink character recognition, MICR. The main advantage of MICR is that it is fast and less error prone. Next is the optical character reader, OCR. OCR is an input device used to read a printed text. OCR scans the text optically, character by character, converts them into machine readable code and stores the text on the system memory. Next is the barcode reader. Barcode reader is also a device, input device used for reading a barcode coded data in the form of light and dark lines. Barcode data is generally used in labeling goods, numbering the books. It may be handheld scanner or may be embedded in a stationary scanner. Barcode reader scans a barcode image, converts it into alphanumeric value, which is then fed to the computer that the barcode reader is connected to. Next is the optical mark reader, OMR. This OMR is a special type of optical scanner used to recognize the type of mark made by pen or pencil. It is used where one out of a few alternatives is to be selected and marked. So this OMR is used to read the OMR sheet. Online, we are giving the exams online. On the OMR sheet, you are giving the exams. Four options are given, A, B, C, D, and we are marking only one option. So to read that sheet, to evaluate the answers of that sheet, OMR is used. Next, the output devices. So this output unit is used for displaying the or printing the process data. Output devices are used for displaying or printing the process data in a user readable form that user can read it. So a computer has several output devices attached to it, and some of the common output devices are the monitors, graphic plotter and printers. Now see the monitors. These monitors are commonly called VDU, visual display unit, the main output device of a computer. It forms images from tiny dots called pixels and that are arranged in a rectangular form. The sharpness of the image depends upon the number of pixels. If the number of pixels is more sharp will be the image. There are two kinds of viewing screen used for monitors, CRT cathode ray tube and flat panel display. See what is the CRT cathode ray tube. So these monitors are of three types. Cathode ray tube, liquid crystal display, LCD, and the TFT monitors, thin film transistors, and third LED monitors, light emitting diode. So the pixels, the resolution of the monitor screen is 1920x1080, means 1920 pixels is the width and height is 1080 pixels. If suppose the resolution of any monitor is given 1920x1080, that is the 1920 is the width of the monitor and 1080 is the height. Okay, now CRT monitor. Cathode ray tube is a small made up of a small picture elements called pixel. The smaller the pixel, the better the image clarity or resolution. It takes more than one illuminated pixel to form a whole character, such as the letter small e in the word help. So this letter small e is also made with more than one pixels. A finite number of characters can be displayed on a screen at once. The screen can be divided into a series of character boxes. Fixed location on the screen where a standard character can be placed. Most screens are capable of displaying 80 characters of data horizontally and 25 lines vertically. There are some disadvantages of the CRT. Large in size and high power consumption is the disadvantage of the CRT monitor. CRT monitors are bulky and occupy a lot of space. They are available in size 14 inch CRT, 15 inch, 17 inch and 20 inch CRT. Next is the flat panel display monitor. This flat panel display refers to a class of video devices that have reduced volume, weight and power requirement in comparison to the CRT. You can hang them on walls or wear them on your wrist. So current uses of flat panel display includes calculators, video games, monitors, laptops, computers and graphics display. This is the flat panel. It is divided into two categories, emissive display and non-emissive display. Emissive displays are devices that convert the electrical energy into light, for example plasma panel and LED. This is the emissive display. Non-emissive display use optical effects to convert the sunlight or light from some other sources into graphic patterns, example LCD, liquid crystal devices. And this LCD are relatively thinner and lighter than the CRT monitor. They use the light modulating properties of the liquid crystals, and these liquid crystals do not emit light directly. They save a lot of space and can be mounted on walls. So this LCD provide a wide viewing angle and come in various size range from 17 inch to 16 inch. They display sharp images and require less power to run. Next is the light emitting diode display, LED. So this LED display is the latest development in the field of the monitor. The monitors are light emitting diodes, act as a performance boosters in them. LED monitors offer better color quality, clarity and display than the LCD monitors. These monitors are flat, thinner and lighter in weight. The biggest advantage of LED display is its efficient and low energy consumption, which is specially needed for handheld and chargeable devices such as mobile phones, tablets and laptops. Next, you can see the touch screen monitor. It's a special monitor that allows the user to input information by touching the icons or graphic buttons present on the screen. One can enter only a limited amount of data by using the touch screen technology. You can see in the ATM machines where by touching we are operating the ATM machine. It is used in the ATM machine offices and cineplexes to retrieve the desired information. Touchscreen monitors are used in many supermarkets and museums to give information about the products and objects of the historical importance respectively. Next, printer. This printer is also an output device used to print information on paper. There are two types of the printers: impact printers, non-impact printers. See, what is the impact printers? Impact printers prints the characters by striking them on the ribbon, which is then pressed on the paper. Characteristics of impact printers are the following: very low consumable cost, very noisy, useful for bulk printing due to low cost. There is a physical contact with the paper to produce an image in the impact printer. So you find there is a physical contact with the paper to produce an image, just like a typewriter hits the paper. Similarly, this impact printer hits the paper. These printers are of two types: the character printer and line printer. Character printers are the printers which print one character at a time. And this character printer is divided into two types: dot matrix and daisy wheel printers. So dot matrix printer is a popular printer. The printers are, because of their case, because of their ease of printing and control price, each character printed is in the form of pattern of dots and head consists of a matrix of pins of size 5x7, 7x9, 9x7, 9x9, which come out to form a character which is called dot matrix printer. This is the dot matrix printer you can see. Basically, you can find this in the LIC office they are using for printing the bills. Advantages of this dot matrix printer: inexpensive, widely used, and other language characters can be printed. Disadvantage: slow speed and poor quality. So dot matrix printers have either 9 pins or 24 pins on the print head, and they use a matrix of small pins to create the precise dots on paper to form characters. and the speed of the dot matrix ranges from 50 character per second to 500 character per second. Daisy wheel printers have good letter formation capability but cannot produce graphics. So they produce letter quality document. The speed of these printers varies from 60 character per second to 120 character per second. Now they are not used in many anymore since because they are very slow and noisy. Next, the non-impact printers. Daisy wheel, you can see here, head is lying on a wheel and pins corresponding to the characters like petals of daisy flower, which is called daisy wheel printer. These printers are generally used for word processing in offices that require a few letters to be sent here and there with a very nice quality. More reliable than DMP, better quality, fonts of characters can be easily changed. Dot matrix printer DMP. This format is slower than dot matrix printer, noisy, more expensive than DMP. Line printers, you can see here. Line printers are the printers which print one line at a time. There are two types, drum printer and chain printer. So this printer is like a drum in shape and hence it is called a drum printer. The surface of the drum is divided into a number of tracks. Total tracks are equal to the size of the paper. That is, for a paper width of 132 characters, drum will have 132 tracks. A character set is imposed on the track. Different character sets available in the market are 48 character set, 64, 96 character set. One rotation of drum prints one line. Drum printers are fast in speed and can print 300 to 2000 lines per minute. Advantage, very high speed. Disadvantage, very expensive. Character fonts cannot be changed. So now this is all for the today, students. Next class we will continue our discussion about the printers, non-impact printers. Thank you for your kind attention.